King Edward.
King Edward.
They lost their nerve. George said he would behead me, but of course he would not dare. Not even Warwick has the stomach for that. He thought I was still that boy that he could control. He tried to make me give you up, but I told him that I would happily stay in his house forever, but never would I give up my wife nor who I am.
They are fools to think it.
So he just released you?
And Parliament wouldn't declare for George and make him king. So if Edward wouldn't abdicate and they wouldn't kill him...
Warwick let me out for exercise so he could save his pride.
But really, he just let him go.
And now he will be sorry. You know about my brother John and father. So they will pay for it.
You won't like it, but they won't. We must have peace, Elizabeth. And I was a fool not to see that I had shut Lord Warwick out. He knows that he has lost, and he will beg for my forgiveness, as will George.
You must not give it.
I will. They're my brother and my cousin. And this country cannot stand another war, especially one within this family. And I will make Warwick's nephew Duke of Bedford.
My first husband's title?
He's Warwick's heir. And I must give him some stake in staying loyal.
He is a traitor. I don't care what his nephew gets, as long as you execute Warwick.
I can't, my love. And I won't. And what is more, I will give our daughter Elizabeth to young Bedford in marriage to make that alliance firm.
Over my dead body.
You must, for then even Warwick will have a chance of his blood being on the throne one day, and he will not come against me again.
I swear to you that she will never marry Warwick's nephew.
Well, then forgive me for being worried out of my wits about you and trying to keep you safe, but they would have murdered you. So while I'm King of England, I shall give my daughter in marriage to anybody I please, and no one, including you, shall stop me.